With the emergency approval of another COVID-19 vaccine, Malacañang insists the country's vaccination program is not lagging behind. Duterte spokesman Harry Roque points out only a handful of countries have started inoculating their citizens. Roque adds so far only Israel and the United Arab Emirates were able to administer COVID-19 vaccines to at least 20% of their population.
Ang pinakamataas po talaga ay Israel. Okay, ang Israel po talaga nandoon sa tuktok pero kakaunti lang din po ang populasyon ng Israel. Pagkatapos po ng Israel, ang UAE po ang pinakamataas na porsyento, 2,248,069 ng katao or 20.9%. Okay? Otherwise po, halos lahat. Bukod po sa dalawang country na ito, ang pinakamataas na po siguro ay 5%, which is the United States.
Some 50,000 countries around the world have already started vaccinating their population against COVID-19. Over in Europe, the row between the European Union and AstraZeneca escalates. As this report tells us, the bloc is now demanding the firm to publish their contract on vaccine supplies following delays in delivery.
The European Union remains dissatisfied with what it called insufficient explanations from pharmaceutical firm AstraZeneca on delays in vaccine deliveries within the bloc. EU Health Commissioner Stella Kyriakides speaking on Monday.
The European Union wants to know exactly which doses have been produced where by AstraZeneca so far and if or to whom they have been delivered. These questions were also discussed today in the joint steering board of the Commission and the 27 member states with AstraZeneca. The answers of the company have not been satisfactory so far.
She also said that in future, manufacturers of COVID-19 vaccines will have to register planned exports outside the bloc. And an EU official told Reuters that a transparency register will be implemented in the coming days.
We want clarity on transactions and full transparency concerning the export of vaccines from the EU. In the future, all companies producing vaccines against COVID-19 in the EU will have to provide early notification whenever they want to export vaccines to third countries. Humanitarian deliveries are, of course, not affected by this. The European Union will take any action required to protect its citizens and rights.
The EU's reaction comes after AstraZeneca announced last week it would fail to meet its first quarter supply targets to mainland Europe.
The World Health Organization is confident vaccines being developed against COVID-19 can quickly adapt to new variants. There are concerns the vaccines being rolled out could be less effective against the new mutations of the virus. But the WHO says the public should not panic since developers are closely monitoring the effects of the new variant. Moderna and Pfizer earlier said their vaccines still work against the new and more contagious variants of COVID-19.
We have no evidence thus far that the vaccines will be any less effective. But that can happen. Look at influenza. We change the vaccine composition twice a year for the northern and southern hemisphere, and we're able to issue vaccines very, very quickly to combat the predominant flu strains every year.